Hey Al, Kurt Sasso here from TGT Web Comics. We're here at Kids Read Comics, and we're here with Jim from Board of Superhero. How are you doing today, Jim?
Oh, I'm doing okay.
Now you're the writer of this wonderful comic, are you not?
I write some of them. It was created by Matt Fazell. It's his Cynical Man character. That's cynicalman.com. And so he's been doing it for like 30 years, and a lot of people haven't seen his older work. So I said, well, why don't we take and collect just strictly the Board of Superhero strips? That's the Board of Superheroes, Cynical Man's day job. And so we just collected them, and it ended up there was just the perfect amount to do a full-size comic. So we said, all right, well, why don't we do that? But then Matt is one of the pioneers of mini comics, so I said we could rearrange it and make two mini comics out of the full-size comic. So that's what we've been doing.
Well, that's great to see. And how did you and Matt get involved?
Well, I first met Matt at Space, the space show in Ohio in 2001, and he just said, oh, where are you from? I said, oh, I'm from Mount Clemens. He goes, oh, well, we're a Detroit cartoonist group. And he goes, you have to come down and cartoon with us. So every Wednesday, we cartoon, and everyone that comes through, we try and cajole, and he gets some big names to come through. Probably the biggest so far has been Scott McCloud. He usually sits in, and that's a nice surprise. I don't know.
Scott's one of my heroes type deal. It's amazing of how much work he's put into the comic industry and web comics and all that. And it's a great guy. You
know? Oh yeah. Well, I was surprised because before I met Matt, I had known him through Understanding Comics, and then I remember saying, oh, look, you're on page 75 and you're on page 108 or so, and he said, so he took my copy, opened it up to the introduction, which he was in. I said, wow, I guess I'd always just skip that. But it was like, if that wasn't my copy, I would have thought that was a parlor trick, But so I went to his first cartooning meeting, and he's been doing work doing Comic Zones and Disney Adventures magazine. And so just eventually got up the courage and I said, do you ever need ideas? And he said, well, so I just started pitching some ideas, and they started buying them, so it worked out well. So I think we did that for maybe 3 or 4 years together, and then Disney decided to change directions, so they shut the magazine down.
And I remember seeing those in the local stores type deal, and I'd pick it up, flip through, and really enjoy like DuckTales or something that. And
I think they got the same benefit that Archie has, where maybe grandparents or parents taking the kids through the lines, and it's like, Disney, I know there's not going to be anything in there I have to worry about. I can give this. That's probably the beauty of Archie. They may not be, they don't go up in sales, but they don't go down in sales. They probably print their exact order every week.
And, how did you get involved with Kids Read Comics?
Well, I know Dan Merritt, one of the people helped put it on from Green Brain Comics. That's the, it's not my local comic store, but that's the comic store I say is my comic store.
do you personally have a website?
Yeah, it's shdvd.tv. We do, we also do animation, and live video, and as well as print. And we're streaming we're actually doing a movie of Cynical Man. So you can see the trailer for it on cynicalman.com. Or if you go on YouTube and search Cynical Man, you can see three of the cartoons we've done.
That's amazing. I definitely want to take a look and check that out. And, Jim, it's been a real pleasure speaking with you, and I hope you have a great weekend here today at Kids Read Comics.
Well, thank you.